हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ रिटर्न्स अंडर जीएसटी। दिस इज सेकेंड हाफ ऑफ योर यूनिट नंबर 4। ओके, सो रिटर्न फाइलिंग इज एक्चुअली अ कम्युनिकेशन मेड टू द गवर्नमेंट अबाउट द बिजनेस ट्रांजैक्शन और इनकम्स एंड एक्सपेंसेस इन द स्पेसिफिक टाइम पीरियड। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस रिटर्न फाइलिंग? इट इज एक्चुअली कम्युनिकेशन। ओके, to the government we are telling that sir, these are the incomes and these are the expenses that we have encountered in this month. And how will you tell it to the government? You are telling it through filing the GST returns online, right? So that is the return filing. These returns are used by tax authorities to calculate net tax liabilities. Now, why do we have to file these returns? It is because to calculate net tax liability. Government wants to know what is your tax liability and how much taxes you are paying to the government. And therefore, these return filing are important. Under GST, return is a statement that contains details of supplies made or received by the registered person. Made or received means that is what we are speaking about, incomes and expenses. Here it is furnished to the government through proper channel. Proper channel, it should go to the government through proper channel. Okay, you cannot randomly write a letter to the government saying that these are my income and expenses. No. There is a proper format, and that is given for the proper administration of tax. It is given by the government only, right? So there is a proper channel, like we have GST website, like we have income tax website, and there is proper format given, and only through that format we have to file the returns, right? Next, what is this QRMP scheme? Most people do not know what is this QRMP scheme. QRMP scheme is given by the government. Let us first understand what is this QRMP. It is quarterly return filing and monthly payment. It means you are filing return quarterly and you are paying monthly. That is QRMP scheme. Okay, quarterly return filing and monthly payment. See, registered persons may file their returns either monthly or quarterly with effect from 1st January 2021. So in this current year, current calendar year, let us say, you can opt for QRMP scheme. Okay, this depends upon what type of registration they have opted. This is very important because small dealers whose turnover is less than 5 crore can choose to opt for quarterly return filing to reduce their compliance cost. Understanding? See, to reduce the compliance cost, only small dealers whose total turnover in 1 year is less than 5 crores, only for them QRMP scheme is available, not for the large companies. Any such business which has a turnover more than 5 crores, even 5 crore 1 rupee is your turnover, then QRMP scheme is not available for you, right? Why it is done? See, there are many small shops, grocery shops, paint shop, hardware shop, clothes shop. There are many shops like retail shops, and they cannot file return every month, but they want to take registration normally. They do not want to go to a composition scheme. In such cases, QRMP scheme is one such scheme they can opt for. They can either file their returns monthly or quarterly. Once if you choose quarterly, for one that whole year, you have to file the return quarterly. If you choose monthly, for at least that year, you have to file monthly returns, and you cannot change that within that year. Okay, this is important point. So the taxpayers who have opted for QRMP scheme can use the invoice furnishing facility, IFF we call it as. okay, those who have opted for QRMP scheme, they can use invoice furnishing facility, which allows quarterly GSTR1 filers to upload their invoices every month. Now, what do we mean by this? See, there are some people who are quarterly filing GSTR1. What is this GSTR1? That is outward supply. If you are filing outward supply quarterly, let me just tell you, show you what is this GSTR4. GSTR4 is outward supply. I'm sorry, that is for composition scheme, right? GSTR1 is outward supply, right? We are going through here this point, GSTR1, that is outward supply, and that is monthly for normal taxpayer, and that is quarterly for QRMP scheme. This is just the next slide, we'll go there, but only to show you what is this GSTR1. I had opened that slide. So you can file quarterly returns GSTR1 to upload their invoices every month, right? What is this invoice furnishing facility? You are filing returns, I repeat, you are filing returns quarterly, but you are uploading the invoices every month, right? And where do you upload this? It is in this invoice furnishing facility. This is one section in your GST portal. Hope you are understanding this. The IFF can be utilized only for the first 2 months of a quarter. This is again the additional point. IFF facility can be used only for first 2 months of a quarter. It means for third month and for third month you cannot do that. It is because after third month, that will be a quarter and you will be filing the whole returns, right? And that is, see, GSTR1 you are filing and it includes everything. Hope you are understanding. So only for first 2 months, IFA facility is there. And in the third month, you file GSTR1 over under QRMP scheme. The details submitted in IFF will be reflected in the GSTR 2A. What is this 2A? Inward supply. 3B, see, why 2A? Sir, you are speaking about GSTR 1 here and why not GSTR 2? GSTR 2 is suspended because of its complexity. Government has suspended GSTR 2 and another GSTR 2A has been given. 2B is also given. GSTR 4A is also given, or GSTR 6A for the recipients, in as the case may be, right? Whatever is your IFF, whatever you are giving IFF, those will be shown or reflected in GSTR 2A, 2B or GSTR 4A and 6A. As the case may be. Next, what are the types of GST returns? GSTR1 is outward supply. GSTR 2 is inward supply. This is suspended. This is also suspended. What is GSTR 3? It is monthly return. And monthly return, in this monthly return, you are telling about outward supply and inward supply both. Don't you think this is double work and extra work? See, outward supply you are giving, inward supply you are giving, and again monthly return you are giving both. Every month you will have to file these returns. What is the frequency? Frequency is monthly. See, GSTR 1 you can monthly file your returns, and quarterly you file your returns under QRMP scheme, and monthly, see, GSTR 2 is also monthly, GSTR 3 is also monthly. Now, what is the due date? 11th of next month, with effect from October 2018 until September 2020, was the due date for GSTR 1. And 13th of succeeding the quarter means if the quarter ends on March, then 13th of April will be the last date under QRMP scheme. For monthly return GSTR 2 and GSTR 3, it is suspended. Let us assume that that is 20th, right? Now, what is this GSTR 3B? It is summary of outward supplies along with input tax credit is declared and payment of tax is affected by the taxpayer. For monthly returns, it is 20th of next month. Okay, and this is changed. Why it is changed, where it is changed, we will see at the end of the table. And for quarterly returns, 22nd or 24th of the next month, next to the quarter, right? I give you an example. If your quarter ends on March, then April 22nd or April 24th of the next month, next to the quarter will be considered for what? GSTR 3B. For whom it is 22 and 24, we will see at the end of the table. GSTR 4 is for composition scheme and that has to be filed annually 30th of the month succeeding financial year. Earlier that was also quarterly, but finance minister through her budget speech since 2020, she said that the composition scheme dealer should file their returns annually, right? And 30th of the month succeeding the financial year will be considered. Financial year means 31st March will be the last date and 30th April will be the last date to file GSTR 4. Now what is this GSTR 5? Return for a non-resident foreign taxable person, NRTP. We have seen section 27, right? Non-resident taxable person, monthly return it is, and 20th of the next month. GSTR 6 is for input service distributor, that is also monthly, 13th of the next month. And then GSTR 7 is for TDS, GSTR 8 for TCS, both are monthly returns, and 10th of the next month will be the last date. GSTR 9 is annual return. GSTR 9 is annual return for any taxable person. Annually, they have to file returns and 31st December of the next financial year will be considered, right? And GSTR 8, let me tell you friends, TCS, who collects this through, if any supply is made through e-commerce operators, then TCS is applicable, okay? And that is monthly. I forgot to show you this. And now GSTR 9A, which is suspended. Why it is suspended? Annual return optional for filing by taxable person or taxpayer registered under the composition levy anytime during the financial year. See what happens here is that GSTR 9A, why it is suspended? If you look at this GSTR 4, it is also for composition scheme and they are filing annually. GSTR 9A, that is also annual return for composition scheme, right? Then why two returns they have to file? Now if you are filing GSTR 4, that is enough, they said, and this is suspended, right? Next, GSTR 9C is for certified conciliation statement. Certified, who has to certify? Chartered accountant has to certify, and that is annually. 31st December of next financial year will be the last date. Next financial year, it means for the year January to December 2020, last date will be 31st December of 2021. Okay, one full year is given because it has to be certified through chartered accountant or cost accountant, let us say, right? Then GSTR 10, final return to be filed by the taxpayer whose GST registration is cancelled. GSTR 10 is the final return. इसके बाद आपको GST registration में नहीं रहना है, आपको GST registration वापस करना है, तो GSTR 10 file करो. It has to be filed once and there is no such final date or recurring date. One time you are filing this return and therefore the date is also given within 3 months of the date of cancellation of registration or the date of cancellation order, whichever is later, right? That will be your date of filing return. Suppose in the month of May, if you cancel your GST registration in the month of May, then within 3 months, that is June, July and August, till August 31, you have the time, you have to file this return. Which return? GSTR 10, one final return, right? Then GSTR 11 is for all the inward supplies to be furnished by a person having UIN and claiming a refund. Okay, what is UIN? Unique Identification Number. If you have this UIN, then you have to file this monthly return, and 28th of the month following the month for which statement is filed is the last date, right? It means for the month of let us say June, 28th of July is the last date, right? Hope you have all understood this. This is a complete 15 marks question. Explain the types of returns under GST. You can give this table and get all 15 marks. You need not explain because every explanation is given here, right? Next, changes suggested in GST returns. At the end of table, which I had said, we are just continuing with it. GSTR 3B, monthly returns. 20th of the month, the taxpayer, for the taxpayers with an aggregate turnover in the previous financial year is more than rupees 5 crore or otherwise eligible, but still opting out of the QRMP scheme. So for those who are not in the QRMP scheme, 20th of the next month is the last date to file the GSTR 3B, which is a monthly return. Okay. And 28th of the next month of taxpayer with an aggregate turnover in the previous financial year is more than 5 crore. We see here they have purely given QRMP scheme and you are still opting out of QRMP scheme 20th. And here there is no scope for QRMP scheme. You are regular person, you are regularly registered person, normal registered person, section 22 or section 24, normally registered person. See, 20th of the next month is your last day to file your GSTR 3B and monthly returns. For the taxpayers with aggregate turnover equal to or below 5 crore, 22nd of the next month, they have to consider. For whom? For category X states and union territories, and 24th of the next month for taxpayers in category Y states or union territories. So category X and Y is given here. Okay. Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Goa, all these are category X. Category X are the normal normal states and union territories, and therefore 22nd of the next month, for whom? For those people who are opting for QRMP scheme, right? Because their aggregate turnover is less than or equal to 5 crore rupees. For all these categories, category X, 22nd is the last date. Category Y, 24 is the last date, right? I will go back to the chart, GSTR 3B. Let me show you that. 22nd or 24th of the next month, next to financial, next to the quarter that we have seen here, because they are filing quarterly, right? For whom it is 22nd, it is category X. For whom it is 24, it is category Y, right? So you just pause this video and read all the category X and category Y states, right? If you ask me, sir, do we have to write these many states in the examination? I think no need if you are a RCU student, but if you are a CA student, CS student or any other professional courses, you better write it all, right? How to remember these all? See, this is easy. All those broad states where business is the prime concern, like Gujarat business, Maharashtra business, Karnataka, Goa business, right? So all put all those into category X. Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Haryana, let us say Uttar Pradesh is also a big state, but fine, there are some exclusions for this general rule which I'm speaking, right? So see, maximum states like Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, see, Meghalaya, what are these? These are the states which are northeastern states or hilly states. They are put into category Y, and therefore this 24th of the next month they have just given, right? Hope this is clear. And for quarterly returns, for the taxpayers with aggregate turnover equal to or below the 5 crore eligible and remain opted into the QRMP scheme 22nd of the next month of the to the quarter for category X and UT, and 24th of the next month. See, the same thing which we have spoken here, 22nd for category X, 24 for the category Y. This is what you will have to understand, right? So there are some changes suggested in GST returns composition scheme dealers, which is the quarterly return. CMP08 is the form name. Okay, so statement cum chalan to make tax payment by a taxpayer registered under composition scheme under the section 10 of CGST Act. Section 10 is what? Composition scheme, right? And CGST rate notification number, this all is notification number given. The due date is 18th of the month succeeding the quarter. This is the change that they have suggested, right? For those people who are choosing for composition scheme, and 08 is the number of form, that is statement cum chalan to make the tax payment by the taxpayer. Okay, so if you are making the payment, that is the 18th of the month succeeding the quarter will be the last date for for composition scheme dealer. Then you will ask me, sir, which one to write? Write both. Okay, next. GSTR 4 for composition dealer under Section 10 of CGST Act, supplier of goods and CGST notification number. See, for supplier of services, for these people, GSTR 4, what they have said, the same thing. There are small changes that they have suggested. Hope this is clear. So that's all about today's class. We have seen a very important question and two important questions, that is QRMP scheme, what is this return filing? 2 marks question can be asked, what is return filing? 2 marks question can be asked, what is QRMP scheme? Or 5 marks question can also be asked. And this 15 marks question, what are the types of GST returns? This has been asked many times. Please go through this chart, copy this all, and learn it properly. Okay, so let us wind up for today's class. We have seen all the returns GSTR 1 to GSTR 20, 11. Please pause the video wherever required and copy down everything. This is a compulsory question, that is types of GST returns. You need not write changes suggested in GST returns when you are writing this table. Okay, so that's all for today's class. We will see the late fees and other proceedings later. Okay, see you next video. Thank you.